Welcome back. We are talking to Dr. Masood Raja. How do you see that the gap that exists between administration and faculty can be bridged up? Can you see some solutions or ways through which we can minimize or bridge up this gap?
Well, I mean, to be frank, this gap is huge in United States as well. You know, in all universities, most of the times the administrators are more highly paid than faculty and they have more power. Now, the way we cater to make sure that it doesn't become a huge imbalance is with different strategies. Now, some universities have faculty that has a full independent faculty union. So they work under a contract which is negotiated every 3 years. My university doesn't have a union, but we have a faculty senate. And our faculty senate has representatives from all departments, and they are the ones who watch policy. They are the ones who see what the administration is trying to do, and then through the faculty senate, we voice our opinions. So, I mean, first few steps here, not necessarily normal, but all Pakistani universities would be, are there mechanisms for faculty to talk to the administration even before something confrontational arises, right? And are there channels which are always open where faculty can reach to the administration and administration to them to see if there are any differences of opinion? Is there some consultation going on the part of the administration when they are taking decisions which could impact faculty's lives as well as their work? So that's something that can be done procedurally by making laws within universities and rules. But I think the bigger change that we need is the change in attitudes, how we treat each other. And that needs to be done on a humanistic level. Ab ye dekhenge, the fark jo maine ye dekha hai, ke despite the disparity of power, jab main apne kisi dean ke paas jata hoon, ya main vice president ke paas jata hoon, at the end of the day, they will decide whether they are going to give me what I'm asking for or not. Theek hai? Lekin they will be polite, they will be professional. In my 12, 13 years of dealing with administrators, I've never had an administrator who has even given me a hint that he is trying to patronize me or anything. Now, can we say that about our own institutions? Agar nahi hai, so that needs to be changed. The administrators need to be trained as to how to interact with faculty. So the question then arises, ke jo humare jitne bhi administrators hote hain, how many of them have actually had any managerial training? How many of them have been taught how to talk to people who are their faculty, and because of them, the university exists?
So do you think such trainings can really help bridging gaps?
Absolutely. I mean, not just such trainings, at least formal trainings where someone comes and tells them, look, there are these different managerial styles, or someone informally has a discussion with them and says, you know, this is not police, this is not a disciplinary institution, this is an academic education institution, and the norms are different, how you aap ek dusre se jaise baat karte ho, faculty se, administrator faculty se. There should be some decorum in that. There should be respect for faculty. So these are the things that can, on a symbolic level, at least ease out tension and make the working smooth. Okay, hum language jo employ kar rahe hain, usme respect ho dusre ke liye. Wo to khair har kisi ke liye honi chahiye. But we're talking about a specific institutional setting. And then laws to protect that, right? So that faculty know that they are protected if someone transgresses and says something or does something which is not nice, which is illegal, or which is rude. So I think all of these things combined, and I think media can play a huge role in this. I mean, media report everything, but most of the times you never hear what's happening on college campuses unless there is a protest or something. I mean, some media channels could do a series of faculty and how do they feel. Now the problem there would be that faculty would be very afraid of, you know, giving a statement about their own institution in public. I don't know how that would be managed. But still making it an issue at small level, at micro level, and then at national level, I think is the way. Because status quo cannot remain.
sense.
I don't think it's like more cultural factor, because it's a culture where you find more violence. I mean, it's not a culture of cooperation and appreciation and encouragement and equality. So don't you think it's like, do you think culture or culturist to some extent is responsible for our attitudes toward others? Like, how do you comment on
that? I'm saying that all of our identities are socially constructed, right? So there are certain core things that we might inherit from our parents, but at the end of the day, what I become or what you become is based on so many different interactions. Well, how did your parents treat you? Which school did you go? What kind of people you hang out with? All of these things make us into the kind of people we are. So culture has a role to play in that. Now, to assume that our culture is that kind of a culture, I think would be a big indictment of our. I think deep in my heart, as I interact with people, that our culture, by and large, is a culture that encourages respecting others, especially teachers, right? It's the kind of culture which acknowledges that you need to take care of other people. ठीक है, most of our villages or everywhere, at least जो आपके रिश्तेदार हैं उनका तो आप ख्याल रखते हैं ना, ठीक है? So then there is a certain breakdown that is happening. We are adopting modern ways of living and consuming and thinking. So, but we are adopting the worst kind, right? So we are adopting कि जी हमने मॉल से branded purse खरीदना है और हमने ये status symbols जो हैं.
Is it like impact of media or something else is responsible?
Of course, media is out there to sell you things. They are creating desire, and your school system, private school system, is creating desire. Most of your private schools are placing the desire of your young people in this elsewhere abroad, right? Europe or America. So their sensitivities and tastes are no longer what you could call related to Pakistan. They can only be fulfilled if they were in England or America, or if Pakistan becomes like that, right? So that's a huge problem there. Media are playing a role in that. So, I think it would be a combination of acknowledging our ills first and then trying to remedy them, and looking at our educational system and seeing how can we tweak that. And at the end of the day, there is no perfect solution. But I think acknowledging the problem is the first step. वो हमारी तो हम लोगों की तो ज़्यादातर आदत ये होती है ना कि हम पहले ही नाराज हो जाते हैं कि जी तुसी साढ़े चाहे जड़ा ना बड़े नक्स काट देते हैं एज अ क्रिटिक. तो अगर वो उस स्टेज से हम गुजर जाएं, एक दफ़ा एक्नॉलेज कर लें कि हमारे में कुछ चीज़ें गलत हैं जो ठीक की जा सकती हैं, तो देन आई थिंक ओनली देन कैन वी मूव इन टू द रिमेडियल थिंग्स.
Coming to the governance structure in Pakistan, because you have a lot of interest in South Asia, how do you see the governance structure in Pakistan? What problems Pakistani governance system, how do you see our governance system? Do you think it needs to improve, or what are the areas where you think improvement is required?
But of course, our government needs to improve, right? And the areas in which it needs to improve is first in terms of its transparency. We as people have the right to know how much money is coming in, who is getting it, how is it being distributed, is it being reported, right? So that we know if someone is appeasing their relative or uncle, it should be out there in the public. Part of that function is that of the media. But even on the larger scale, I think what we have lacked as a nation is this continuity of a system that's accountable to the people. Ab yahan pe Pakistan mein to hum, it's bahut aasan hai siyasadanon ko bura kehna. Siyasat is messy. You have to make compromises. Aapne 15-15 bandon ke paas ja ke unse baat karni hai, tab aapne unko manana hai. That's how politics works. So it's very easy to point a finger and say, oh, ye dekho, humne tumko kaha tha siyasadan sare jo hain, ये करप्ट हैं, ये चोरों का टोला है, एक तो ये भी लफ्ज आजकल यूज हो रहा है. तो बट द आइडिया इज दैट इफ वी डू इट ओवर 60-70 इयर्स, इवेंचुअली पीपल, इवन इफ दे आर अनलेटर्ड एंड डोंट गो टू स्कूल, दे नो देयर पॉलिटिकल सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट. आप अपने गांव में जाएं, मैं अपने गांव में जाता हूं, आपके जो जिनको हम कहते हैं ये पढ़े लिखे लोग नहीं हैं, उनसे अगर आप पूछें कि उनको क्या क्या चाहिए और क्या क्या मिलना चाहिए, उनको पता है हम क्या हमें चाहिए एक आजाद मुल्क. उनको किसी टेक्स्ट बुक में वो पढ़ने की ज़रूरत ही नहीं है, उनको मेरे आपके या किसी बहुत बड़े सियासतदान को भी ये बताने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. तो इट मेक्स मी रियली सैड व्हेन पीपल से समवन हैज सडनली कम आफ्टर 67 इयर्स एंड टॉट पाकिस्तानी पीपल हाउ टू थिंक अबाउट देयर राइट्स. इट आई थिंक इट्स अ डिसर्विस टू पाकिस्तानी पीपल बिकॉज वी आर अस्यूमिंग कि इट टेक्स वन पर्सन आफ्टर 68 ईयर्स ऑफ वेटिंग टू कम एंड टीच अस के हमारे हकूक क्या हैं. आई मीन आप वो जो रेड़ी वाला आपके जो बेच रहा है पकौड़े बेच रहा है या केले बेच रहा है, डोंट यू थिंक कि उसको पता है कि जब पुलिस वाला आके उससे रिश्वत मांगता है तो उसका हक मारा जा रहा है. मैंने और आपने तो उसको ये नहीं पढ़ाना ना, वो तो उसको ह्यूमन लेवल पे पता है. तो टू मेक गवर्नमेंट रिस्पॉन्सिव राइट सो दैट इट नोज इट थिंक्स फॉर द लोएस्ट ऑफ द लो राइट एंड इमेजिन एंड दैट्स प्योरली ट्रूली इस्लामिक एज वेल कि जो आपके माशरे में सबसे कमज़ोर है उसका सोचो पहले, सबसे ताकतवर का ना सोचो. ताकतवर ने तो अपना हिसाब किसी से भी छीन लेना है. ठीक है, अब वो होगा कैसे? योर आर गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट, नो थर्ड वर्ल्ड गवर्नमेंट इज इंडिपेंडेंट. दिस इकोनॉमिक सिस्टम दैट वी कॉल न्यू लिबरलिज्म इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड टू मेक श्योर दैट द नेशंस दैट हैव द पोटेंशियल एंड वेल्थ कैन रिटेन इट. Right, all of us are playing a game. हमारी जो current government है वो भी उस खेल में शामिल है. क्यों? कि their hands are tied. Every 3 months they have to go back to IMF and say कि हमें थोड़ा सा कर्जा और दे दो ताकि जो पहले आपने हमें कर्जा दिया हुआ है उसका interest हम आपको दे दें. So this is an unjust political economic system. We will never catch up. आज से आप मैं और हम सब मिलके 24 घंटे काम करना शुरू कर दें और बिल्कुल ऑनेस्ट हो जाएं, कोई करप्शन ना आए, वी विल स्टिल नॉट कैच अप विद द डेवलप्ड वर्ल्ड बिकॉज द सिस्टम इज इम्बैलेंस्ड. सो एक्नॉलेजिंग दैट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग राइट, नोइंग इट. अब उसमें हमारा क्या है? हमने पिछली दफा जब वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने नए रूल्स निकाले ट्रेड लिबरलाइजेशन और सब के, हमारे जो वजीर खजाना थे उनका मुझे नाम भूला हुआ है, वो गए निगोशिएट करने. इंडिया का वज़ीर ख़जाना भी गया नेगोशिएट करने. इंडिया के वज़ीर ख़जाना ने पढ़ा डॉक्यूमेंट, उसने 141 या 145 ऑब्जेक्शनें लगाई उसके ऊपर कि इससे हमारे मज़दूरों का ये जाएगा, इससे हमारे जो चावल के काश्तकार हैं उनका हक मारा जाएगा. वी हैव 141 ऑब्जर्वेशन राइट. नाउ गेस हाउ मैनी ऑब्जर्वेशन डिड आर फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर मेड? नथिंग. उन्होंने पढ़ा ही नहीं, उसके ऊपर ठप्पा लगा के आ गए. तो अगर ये इनके हालात हैं तो जाहिर है इसमें कौम की तो गलती नहीं है ना. कौम ने जिनको इलेक्ट करके ऊपर भेजा है उनका काम है टू प्रोटेक्ट देयर ओन पीपल, बट दे वर्क फॉर द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ ग्लोबल पावर.